The man gave him clear instructions. At 3 a.m. he had to be under the South Bridge, with a note full of homograph's nonsense words that served as safe conduct in case of any setback. The heart wanted to go out of the chest. He furtively looked behind the curtains, the world patrols passing in front of his house, making that little stop that seemed of defiance to him. He timed the interval between each visit and the following, thinking like a metronome the steps he needed to cross to the other side of the street and disappear inside the garden. He waited patiently for the 2 a.m. patrol passed by. He counted to 30, time enough to let the car turn the corner. It would take 40 minutes to the bridge. He closed the door carefully, not making any noise, with a little sigh when he remembered his daughter sleeping upstairs. The garden, with the only lighting of the moon, served as shelter for his fear, and let him walk peacefully to the other side of the city. He saw the bridge from the distance, and had the illusion of seeing his wife waiting for him, although he could see afterwards the woman was not his. She was a tall woman, pretty attractive, but with a distant and severe look. The truth is that she was waiting for him. Leon looked at his clock, and as he saw it was not the time, there were 10 minutes left, he thought it could be a trap. It wasn't. The woman approached and held her hand, asking for the note the other man gave him. She didn't say a word, and even though Leon understood what she wanted, he took the note of the pocket and gave it to her. And the woman read it in seconds. She folded it and put it in a purse that hung it on her shoulder. From now on, there won't be any more notes, the woman said. Leon said, believing that the woman would lead him to Adina. You had to be careful, she answered mysteriously. But Leon started to be fed up with so many mystery, and didn't look very happy. The woman noticed it. I guess they had explained to you how things go, she sentenced. And she sentenced it really clear. In fact, Leon didn't look very nothing again. He literally followed the woman's instructions, and in the morning, once lifted the curfew, went back home to see his daughter. He was tired, but he couldn't miss another day of work. He didn't know how his life would change, but he knew that he had to have a job. He was tired because the woman ordered him to go 3 streets to the south to talk to another man. She made him 4 questions before told him the address of his second meeting. Why did you contact with us for? Who told you to do it? Who gave you the note? How did you come here? Leon answered straight the 2 first questions, vaguely to the 3rd one, and exactly the 4th. The woman stared at him, trying to see the single change that a lie would cause on his pupils. 3 districts to the south was waiting for him, a man with a lost look, kind of scruffy, as he had just waked up in a hurry. He approached carefully and passed in front of him. The man didn't back from his trance, nor gave a sign of being who had to be. Leon, in a first moment, thought, in going straight past and back home, before a patrol sent him to jail. But he saw in a flash the sleeping kid and his wife and decided to pass by another time. I just saw you the first time. You don't have to make a fashion show. The man dropped without a movement. Leon hesitated to say what he was thinking. I meant, who could tell, or something worse. But the man didn't give him time. Come on, to the point. Have you brought the dogs? Leon's heart stopped suddenly. He hadn't brought any money. Dogs? Leon asked. Yes, dogs, cash, money. Didn't they tell you have to bring 200s? The man said with anger. No, nobody told me about the money, Leon answered. And what did you think? That this was for free? The upset man said. Bring 300s tomorrow, for trying to be clever.